My daughter was the most beautiful, outgoing, smart person.
Michelle Applegate says those smarts led to a college scholarship in 2011. Once there, Abigail Thompson's struggle with drugs started.
She was very popular, started hanging around with other affluent, popular kids, and started using cocaine, LSD, mushrooms.
That began a 10-year battle with addiction. She was in 17 recovery programs. Applegate says she went into debt, paying more than $100,000 trying to help her daughter recover. Thompson's longest period of sobriety was 18 months. Applegate says in the summer of 2020, Thompson was back in treatment.
Unfortunately, she met someone in treatment that had just been admitted, that had drugs they used at the program. The program discharged both of them.
Thompson would later overdose on fentanyl and die. She was 27. Dr. Kenneth Stoller is the director of the Johns Hopkins Broadway Center for Addiction. Maryland has the fourth highest mortality rate from drug overdoses in the U.S. Dr. Stoller says the pandemic fueled the rise of overdose deaths in Maryland.
People are alone more. And if they're using alone, there's not people there to call 911 or to use Narcan to revive them. I carry this at all times. This is a life-saving medication that everybody should be carrying so that if somebody overdoses, they could be revived right away.
So on this Awareness Day, what do you most want people to know?
If you're involved with someone who has a substance use disorder, don't give up on them. If they are breathing, there is hope for them to get recovery. Get help for yourself so that you could support loved ones. Don't give up. Always keep that connection there so when they are ready for help, you're able to support them.
Lisa Robinson, WBAL-TV 11 News.